Adhiban joins us after a crushing victory in his beast mode style again in round 6 of the Gibraltar Masters. Adhiban, a dominating win with the white pieces today. Yeah. While playing, did you feel in control throughout?
Yeah, I really wanted to win today and I was feeling quite motivated.
What was your motivation today for winning?
I saw some videos of Lawrence Trent that was in Chess 24. Yeah, that was my motivation today.
Wow, I'm sure he doesn't get that too much. He'll be very happy to hear that. But take us through the critical moments and what happened today.
Yeah, and the opening until here I was playing fast, but then here he started to think. Then I guess that bishop c3 is the main line, but he started to think, so I expected him to go for bishop a5, what he did. And it was just, this is the main line. And here I remembered my preparation from Olympiad, like Vichigov, I think, played with Vidit, and we were checking this for Olympiad, so I thought, okay, I remembered some of it, and then...
Did you actually use that preparation in the Olympiad? Or
no, because I immediately went wrong, actually. F4, bishop d7 is the main line.
Okay.
But even knight c6, so after this, I was on my own, actually.
And he actually took some time for knight c6, so he was probably already out of his
comfort zone. Yeah. Because I think knight c6 is not good. You should put bishop d7, bishop a4 first, and then maybe...
Take out the knight, because now the bishop
just
stays bad.
Yeah, now the bishop is a little bit bad.
Right.
Yeah, then after this, I think, okay, we just probably
this
go to the critical.
This moment seemed quite important here, because tell us, how were you evaluating this position? Because it looks like white is doing well.
Yeah, the thing is, he has literally no plan, actually. His pieces are completely out. He has no counterplay. My only thing is, like, I thought if he gets a long castle, it's not so easy to break through. So that's why I went for this knight g5. Here, I think he started to panic, actually. It is not so bad, like he can do something like, knight d8, and then try to hold like this.
Okay, it does look ugly.
Yeah,
still.
It's really ugly, but I don't have a breakthrough. I need to prepare. Like, I was planning queen f3 and rook e1, something like this.
Okay.
Yeah, it
was but like he also just tries to hold this
position. Yeah, hold the position.
But
this
is quite a nice move, because you just stop him from the idea of long castling, now he's really stuck with nothing to play. Where did it go? Where did Black's position collapse after this?
Yeah, HG4, I think, was already a mistake, because now he gives me a clear target on H5, and he's not in time to protect F7 and also get the king to safety. So after this, I felt it was already very difficult, actually.
So you have a clear plan of just moving the king with Rook H1.
Yeah, Rook H1, and going for the attack,
Very nice.
So after this, I think, it was quite difficult, and actually, I didn't expect... he would resign, but okay. Yeah, I was checking some, I think here it was. I was checking some rook h6, which was also, I took this, here. I could actually take rook h6, knight h6 and queen h3. The point is, he cannot go back, but he, then queen h7 I get.
Right.
And it's like either mate or...
Nice.
But the thing is, after here, he takes knight g4, which I was not so happy about. Somewhere, it looks so crazy. Yeah, but I thought I could win this without giving a pawn. I was being greedy.
So you saw this rook h6, but you like the idea of rook h4 and then going queen h3,
because
h3.
He is just stuck.
He's just completely stuck.
The thing is, he can't create any counter there, actually. So it's really difficult.
He went king f8 and resigned after knight h7. Can you just explain to our viewers why he resigned at this moment?
So he has to go king, I think, g7.
If he goes king e7, your idea is to go
queen
h3 and you want to take then. So you've saved your g4 pawn. Yeah. And if he goes king
g7? G7 and then I go queen, knight f6 first. Knight f6, and he's again stuck, like, actually. He just doesn't have a... And at first I was not so sure, but then I saw queen d8.
You probably have g5 here, do you?
No, I thought even f5 is even stronger, maybe, just killing.
But I'm just looking at this position and...
g5... there was some... Wait, maybe. There was some... Knight f5, maybe?
Rook h7?
No, thing is, rook... rook h7, king f8. Yeah, okay, probably this is just winning.
I thought f8
was...
bad,
yeah.
But then after queen d8, you can also go f5.
Yeah, it just falls apart.
And after king e7...
queen h3, yeah. So, he resigned here, after king and knight
h7,
So,
because your point is to break this double knight defense with knight f6 and then go queen h3,
basically.
Very nice game. pleased with the way you played today, I'm sure.
Yeah, sure, very happy.
26 move win. So I've noticed this thing about you. Whenever you're playing this kind, you're just crushing your opponents very quickly.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to play this endgame grinds for the past few rounds. So I was like, forgot who I was. So so then, okay, I was like, okay, I should play maybe like this more.
So you found yourself
yeah,
again.
Yeah.
Well, that's awesome. As usual, love these kind of games. And thank you for the interesting chess you played. Thank you for your time, Adhiban.
Yeah.
Thanks for joining us.